Finally, the Ballute is getting the attention it deserves. We're talking about that and how Rocket Lab is going to use one. Coming up. 3, 2, 1. Hey guys, Tori here from Overlook Horizon. If you're new to the channel, we fly high altitude weather balloons to the edge of space and back. And along the way, we talk about space and science and technology. So if that's something you're interested in, please consider subscribing. Today, we're talking about Rocket Lab and how they're going to use a Ballute to make their Electron rocket reusable. Now, before we get into what the is a Ballute, first, let's get you up to speed on who Rocket Lab is and what do they do. Rocket Lab is a small satellite launch provider. They make a relatively small launch vehicle, and their main business is launching itty bitty tiny satellites into orbit at a low cost. Traditionally, some of the more well-known launch providers like SpaceX and United Launch Alliance, they focus on big satellites. So those smaller cubesats and microsats and all the little tiny satellites can kind of take a back seat to those. They can still hitch a ride and head to orbit along a Falcon 9 rocket, but they may not be the main payload of that mission. So that means that the orbit that they get dropped off into is kind of at the mercy of what the larger payload is trying to get to. Rocket Lab has been around since 2006, but they really started gaining in popularity since about 2017 when their Electron rocket started doing flights. Now, originally, the Electron rocket was not intended to be reusable, and this is purely because Rocket Lab wanted to focus and stay as a small launch vehicle. Their CEO, Peter Beck, has stated in the past that in order to make the first stage of the Electron rocket reusable, they would have to upgrade the Electronic into a medium launch vehicle just to accommodate all the extra thermal protections and re-entry systems needed to bring the Electron rocket's first stage back to Earth. And for them, that is something they did not want to focus on because they wanted to remain a small launch vehicle focused on launching small satellites. Most of Rocket Lab's launches happens from what they call Launch Complex 1, which is in New Zealand. Now, Rocket Lab is a US-based company out of California, but all of their operations to date have been pretty much in New Zealand. They do now have a second launch pad being built on Wallops Island here in Virginia, and that will be Launch Complex 2 that should be operational by the end of this year. At this point, Rocket Lab now has 7 flights under their belt, and in all of those flights, they've collected a ton of data, not just during launch, but also during the re-entry phase for that first stage. And it's finally at this point that the CEO of Rocket Lab, Peter Beck, has said that he is ready to eat his hat.
So this is a Rocket Lab cap. This is a cap that I'm about to eat because I've said publicly a few times the various things that Rocket Lab would never do. So unfortunately, I find myself in the position of eating my hat.
Because they are now going to move Electron into the reusable category. Now, most of us probably already know that the king of reusability is SpaceX. They land their Falcon 9 rocket either on a drone ship in the middle of the ocean, or sometimes they return it back to the launch site to land at LZ1 or LZ2. Blue Origin can also land the first stage of their rocket, New Shepard. Both SpaceX and Blue Origin land their rockets propulsively, meaning they use the engines to do so. But Rocket Lab is taking a little different approach. Rocket Lab is going to rely on parachutes and a helicopter. This is similar to the approach that United Launch Alliance has announced that they're going to use for their upcoming Vulcan rocket. The way this works is that the Rocket Lab Electron rocket will launch from one of their launch complexes. Out at sea, they'll have a ship with a helicopter. At launch time, they'll launch the rocket and the helicopter will lift off. The early phases of launch are pretty much unchanged. It's after that first stage separates where things start to get interesting. The Electron rocket will re-enter the Earth's atmosphere engine bell first, and there is an incredible amount of energy that needs to be dissipated, both in speed and in heat. Once it has successfully re-entered the Earth's atmosphere, ba-da! That's where we see the Ballute. If you don't know what a Ballute is pretty much a portmanteau of balloon and parachute. And if you don't know what a portmanteau is, it's pretty much two words that they took and just smashed together to make up a new word. Benefits of a Ballute is that it can be deployed at really high speeds. Now, generally, a Ballute, like the one that we see in the Rocket Lab animation, would have intake valves to inflate the Ballute using the outside air. Balloons can also be inflated by a gas like helium using onboard tanks, but I don't think that's what they're gonna do here. After they've used the Ballute to slow themselves down from these ultra high speeds, they'll then deploy a regular or conventional type of parafoil parachute to help steer the rocket and direct it down towards the ocean. But before it lands in the ocean, that's where our helicopter comes in. The helicopter will swoop in with some kind of skyhook, and it appears that their connection point is gonna be somewhere between the Ballute and the parafoil. The helicopter will snag that line, grab onto the rocket, and fly it back to that recovery ship where the helicopter took off from. Now, this is a really ambitious plan for Rocket Lab, and it's going to happen in a number of stages. The first thing that they have to do is get through the wall. Essentially, that means that they have to first work on getting the rocket through the atmosphere in one piece. Once they can successfully do that, then they can focus on the actual helicopter recovery piece. So over the next couple of flights for Rocket Lab, you'll see them working on that re-entry portion. Stuff like this is super exciting, especially in the small sat industry, because the intent of this is to make the Electron rocket rapidly reusable. In theory, the Electron rocket could launch very rapidly after being recovered, especially because they have a lot of electrical components that are battery powered, like their turbo pumps. This could also lead to a reduction in launch costs if that launch vehicle is more easily reused. So this is a pretty exciting time. Now we've got SpaceX and Blue Origin and now Rocket Lab that are going to be focused on reusability. And hopefully soon we'll see United Launch Alliance enter this arena as well. So, question of the day, how long do you think it's going to be until we see a Rocket Lab recovery? Are we talking a year, 2 years, 5 years? Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. Also, let me know if I missed anything. This news is still pretty fresh, so I'm still trying to wrap my head around everything that's going on. As always, thanks to our Patreon supporters for helping make videos like this possible. If this is something that you're interested in and you like this kind of content, please consider liking the video or subscribing to the channel so you can get more of this kind of stuff. Thanks everybody for watching. We'll see you in the next video.